Hello friends, Mandar here. I'm back with another video. Today I'm going to talk about travel outside the United States while pending adjustment of status. Now there have been some interesting questions that I have got recently that can I remain outside of the United States while my application for adjustment of status is pending in the United States? And then there are a lot of other questions about how long can I stay and so on and so forth. So there are some important aspects to remember, because if you don't follow them, you risk abandoning your adjustment of status. So I have made a previous video on it about a couple of months back, but I think given the number of subscribers increase on my channel, I wanted to make this video on important topic because a lot of people on this channel are in adjustment of status. So if you are interested in this topic, watch this video until the end and let's get started. If you are here for the first time, welcome. My name is Mandar and I make immigration related videos for US and Canada. I'm not an immigration lawyer, so anything that I say on this video or on my channel is for information purpose only. And for your specific immigration needs, before you take any action, you should hire a competent immigration lawyer. Now with that said, now let's say if you have your visa application pending with USCIS. Now in this case, if you are in the United States, you have to be careful when you travel. Now let's look at some of the fundamentals. Whenever anybody who is a non-citizen or non-US national enters into the country, they are subject to visa scrutiny. What that means is they are subject to inspection of whether this individual can be allowed into the country. There are two things to that. You should have a proper visa and you should be admissible in the United States. That means you should not have done any crime, felony, or overstated your visa, or have spent any amount of time within the United States where you are out of status. So there are a lot of conditions that have to be met when you are coming inside the United States. The first condition is you need to have a proper visa. If you are a non-citizen and if you are in the United States and if you don't have a document or a visa to return to, you are in trouble. That is the fundamental thing. So now if you are in adjustment of status, you are still maintaining your status in the United States because the fact that you have pending I-485 application, which is adjustment of status, allows you to remain in the United States. But the mere fact of you being in that status does not allow you to travel and come back. So now several other things, depending on what visa you have, say if you have an H-1B, L-1, or if you have an EAD, there are different factors to consider while traveling outside of the United States. First, let's look at what stage you are in the green card process. If you have completely gone through your PERM and I-140 is approved and you are in the 485 stage, you want to make sure that you have a document to come back into the United States. Now that could be your H-1, L-1 stamp on your passport, or at least you should have an approval notice before you leave. Now, second thing to remember is if you are an HL, you need to have a valid stamp while coming back. So if you just the mere fact that you have an approval notice does not give you a right to come back. In that case, you'll have to go to your embassy in the country outside where you are traveling, get your visa stamped on your passport, and only then you can return. So your visa should be valid at the time of entry. The third thing is if you have a combo card, that is EAD and advanced parole card, that combo card, that advanced parole card should have a validity while entering into the United States. Typically, when you get the EAD for the first time, you get it only for the period of 1 year. Now, there is a bill in the Congress where it will extend it to the 2 years period for the first time, but that has not been passed yet. So the first time when you get an EAD on your adjustment of status, it will only be valid for 1 year. So the mere fact that your advance parole and EAD card is valid only for 1 year tells you that you cannot be staying outside of the United States beyond that time. Now there are other bigger implications if you stay for a longer time. Now let's look at what the actual USCIS website says regarding travel outside of the United States on an advance parole. So as you can see on the USCIS website, there is a section for emergency travel. And then here it clearly outlines what it is. In the first line itself, you can see that in case of an emergency and before leaving the United States, you should know that what documents will be required to re-enter the United States, as well as understand whether or not your departure will negatively impact your application for immigration benefit. So you should be very clear on what are the implications while coming back. The general rule of thumb is, unless you are a US citizen, there is no guarantee that you will be allowed into the country, and this includes green card holders. So any person who is not an US citizen or a US national is subject to the scrutiny about whether that person has a green card or a visa and whether that person is admissible into the country. So you got to be very careful. So this matters to people who don't have a clean record. It should not matter to people who have maintained their status and who have been a good citizens while coming back into the United States. And whenever you are entering, you need to have, as I said, a valid visa or a valid advance parole card along with you when you return. Now on this page, it clearly says emergency travel only. Now in this section, it clearly says travel outside the United States may have severe consequences if you are in the process of adjustment of status, that is applying for a green card. In general, if you are seeking immigrant status and depart the United States without the proper documentation, that is advance parole, you may be inadmissible to the United States upon return, or even if admitted, you may be found to have abandoned your application. Now this is a very important point, and this leads me into the question that one of my subscribers had asked. Actually, many of them asked. So here's the situation, what people ask me, that I have my green card application in process. I am in the 485 stage of my application, that is adjustment of status. I have received my EAD and advance parole card. Can I go outside of the United States and stay in my home country for a long period of time? Because for certain backlog countries such as India and China, the wait period, even if you are in the 485 stage, could be several years. So the question is, can I stay in my home country, which is outside of the United States, while my application is pending? Now you got to be very careful in this situation. The reason is, even if you have an advance parole, the card is only valid for 1 year. So if you come back and if your card is not valid, then you will not be allowed. Say for instance, if you did get a good validity period on your card, what USCIS says is advance parole can only be used for emergency travel or a travel which is for a short period of time, say for a week or it could be several months, but no more than that. When you are talking more than 6 months, you will be subject to scrutiny. If you approach 1 year of time spent outside of the United States, even if you have an advance parole to come back, you will be under a lot more scrutiny than anybody else. The reason is, they may consider that you have abandoned your intent to reside in the United States permanently, and that fact alone could disqualify you from coming back into the country. So remember what I said, even if you have an advance parole and if you spend significant amount of time outside of the United States, you might get into trouble. In another scenario, even if you have a non-immigrant status visa, such as H or L, and if you have a pending 485 application, do not go outside the country for more than a short period of time. A short period of time is couple of weeks or maybe a month or two at the most. That is my caution. If you go anywhere beyond, you are risking your application to be abandoned. I know there are few people who have done this in the past, who have been outside of the United States and still were able to have their 485 application intact, but that is very far and between. You are putting yourself in a lot more risk. If USCIS gets a hint that your intention to stay in the United States is not permanent, they can deny your application or they can consider your application abandoned if you stay outside of the United States for a longer period of time. So people who think that they can just go outside of the United States and because their wait period is so long, they can just work from their home country for however long, and then when they get a notification online, they can come back. That should not be done. I will not recommend it to anybody. So even if you have a non-immigrant visa or if you have an advance parole, traveling outside the United States pending adjustment of status should be limited to emergency and a short period of time only. Some people have fallen through the cracks and have gotten away with it, but vast majority of the people will not be lucky in this situation. You should be considering your individual circumstances and consulting with your lawyer before you step out of the United States when your adjustment of status application is pending. So I hope you got some value out of this video. I think there are a lot of people who are stuck in this endless loop. As you may know, the Department of State has progressed the dates a lot. That has allowed a lot of people to apply for 485, but now they are stuck in that endless wait time until their actual green card is actually approved. So this is a very tricky situation because you could be waiting on pending adjustment of status for several years, thinking when can they go out to their home country. If you have to go, I would suggest go for a very short time and come back and make sure you have the documentation to come back, which is your valid H1 or L1 stamp on your visa and a valid advance payroll. So I hope you got value out of this video. If you did, please hit the like button and consider subscribing to my channel, and I'll see you in the next one.